ओके सो नेक्स्ट वन पारंपरेपि प्रधानानुवृत्ति वृत्ति ही अणुवत हूज टेकिंग दिस अप
Fairly straightforward. Even in the line of creation in Prakriti, the Pradhana continues to exist in the, you know, just as an atom continues to exist in different forms in materials.
So this also in some way indicates, Anuj, that some amount of Pradhana.
Yeah. I mean, basically, Pradhana has transformed itself, but it continues to be also Pradhana while it is other things.
Yes,
kind of.
Yes. Okay. The next one.
But this Pradhana, Uttraji, this Pradhana, though it started, creation started, but still the Pradhana stays in the all the Samatva state, no? That the equilibrium continues, but at the same time, the creation also is going on.
All of it is not in that, all of it cannot obviously be in the Samatva state, because unless there is that variation, then karyas will not come out of it. So the very variation in the Sattva, Raja and Tama only leads to the formation of the different karyas.
But so overall, on the average, there is equilibrium of the balance. But in place explained through densities, that is brilliant. So through densities, the variation exists.
Yeah. So again, you can look upon it as you know, sodium and chloride ions, which are there, which are atoms in themselves, but they are different atoms. So then they connect to form salt. Okay, so like that, this Sattva, Raja and Tama, they connect in different proportions to give you the different karyas of this universe.
But all of them are capable to go back to its primordial during the Pralaya, basically, which is when it goes back to that total zero.
So it is just like this sodium ion and chloride ion have come together to form salt, where now it is neither sodium nor chlorine, it is a new substance called salt. And now in this salt, still, even though it's nothing to do now with sodium and chloride, yet it continues to retain the sodium and chlorine atoms in it. So if you had to destroy salt, it will go back into sodium and chlorine atoms.
At one level of destruction. In the total level of destruction, yes, they go back to
one
its...
One level of destruction.
Uttaraji, the Pradhana is the just basic, very basic, tiniest out of the tiniest atom, primordial matter. Okay. Yes. And then from there, when it starts that creation, that is called Prakriti, no? The Pradhana...
Prakriti, as you hear in Sanskrit or in Hindi or any other language, as nature, please do not consider that here. Here it is a technical word which means primordial matter, the Adi Upadana, the one which exists before any other change, is called Prakriti, Pradhan, etc. It has many words. So this is a technical word now.
Okay.
So do not confuse it with the normal usage of Prakriti.
The colloquial Prakriti.
Yeah. Okay. Just as you were confused between Karan and Karya, Karan and Karya have these technical meanings of cause and effect as well. So you must understand that you are now reading physics, where speed and velocity have very, very technical meanings. You cannot use generically speed and velocity as you would in a normal conversation.
Okay, got it.
Okay. Sarvatra karya darshanat vibhutvam.
Can I take it up?
Please take it up.
Yeah. It means that Pradhana has to be existing everywhere.
Yes.
Because the effects are seen all over.
Correct. That's it.
Now, yeah. We also consider, I mean, it also says that the universe is huge, and it the empty space is also part of the universe, though it may not contain anything per se. It is also part of the universe, and that is why we accept that Pradhana is there everywhere.
No, Akash is made of Pradhana.
Yes.
Akash is an element which is made out of Pradhana. So it is not emptiness. It is not nothing.
No, it is part of the universe, no, Raji? That is why we
is
say...
nothing, right? It is not nothing.
Huh, I mean, yeah, nothing. Yeah. I got it. I made that mistake here. Took it casual conversation, yes.
Okay, cool.
All right. So, for example, you take any piece of space anywhere, there is some energy flowing through there. So, if the energy has to flow through, it is a medium for that. So, it has energy flowing through that given moment.
Yeah. So, I think 1950s physics or something, they used to call this thing as ether. Then this Williamson Morley experiment was done, and then they said, no, there is no such thing as ether. And then now again, they have to come out with this thing called dark matter, which is all pervasive. These are some of the things which are all hazy in science. But anyway, at least in our ancient thinking, they were very clear after much thought. Okay, so which was, missed out on which are the previous sutras. This Paramparye Pradhana Anuvritti Ranuvat. Where did it occur earlier?
That is what I was talking about.
what is it you were talking about?
The same Parampar.
Parampar, correct. It is 139. Adhya Etuka Tadwara Paramparya Api Anuvat. Okay. So part
this
of it,
this one is 41. That Parichinna.
Yeah, that's what I said.
Parichinna na sarvopa.
Yeah, correct. Okay, then what about this one? Sarvatra karya darshanat vibhutvam. Which one is this?
That was 40, right?
That was?
41.
Beautiful, Kalam. Fantastic job. That was this one, Prashanti, Parichindam na Sarvopadanam.
Yeah.
Okay, so it is Vibhu. Good job, everybody. And good, Prashanti, that you remembered these things on your own. Okay, Gati Yogi Apya Adhyakaranata Hane Raduvat.
Do you want me today?
Sure.
Okay, I'll try. Okay.
Go ahead.
Let me try that. Okay. Yeah. The question comes, if Pradhana is all pervasive and filled everywhere, and then how can it move? The Gati, how can it move?
Yes.
For that, Kapila explains that it is not in the solid form, but it is in a liquid form.
No.
Yeah.
No.
That's 37.
That is the water example I have given to explain to you.
No, it's actually because of the variation in the density.
Billiard ball, we have given that billiard ball we have done. But I just tried to use that liquid form. If that it is, then only the density will be changing. No, even if the glass full of water, if you look at the density of the water, will change from the higher to the lower. It can happen, though the water is absolutely still. But the movement within that, it can happen. So that's why I just wanted to explain that. You have given about the billiard one.
Billiard for the Anuvat. For the Anuvat. There is an Anuvat here, right? At the end, which is like the atom. So the
like
atom.
That.
Yeah, for explaining that, I have given.
And he says the prakriti is absolutely that, not the colloquial prakriti. Prakriti is a technical word, is always nitya and adimula karna for the creation.
Correct. Okay, so prasiddha adikyam pradhanasya na niyamaha. This we have, I think, discussed. So we'll move on here. Sattvadhinam atad dharmatvam tad rupatvat. This also we have discussed. These do not exist earlier. Then anupapoge api pumartham srishtihi pradhanasyoshtra kumkuma vahanvat. This is very simple.
So the pradhana, may I?
Yes, please.
Yeah, so the pradhana is actually not involved in the bhoga. It is it creates the whole, it is involved in the creation. All these effects happen and that is not for itself to enjoy. Like a camel carrying the saffron.
Correct.
I mean, the camel never tastes it or eats it. It is for the soul.
Correct.
Or the master.
Did this exist earlier?
Sorry?
Where was this concept given earlier? Who knows?
Yeah, it was the same first chapter, no? Where we said that everything is for another. 30 something.
You have to give me the sutra.
I have to give you the sutra. 30 something.
31
of the first chapter.
Yeah.
Sangat paran tatvat purushasya.
Yeah.
To a limited extent, yes. That is one of the sutras. Then. If you look at 358.
We stuck to the first chapter.
Only first chapter.
This is actually 358 almost. Ditto, 358 is Pradhana Srishti Paratham. Swato api abhokta tvat ushtra kumkuma vahanvat. So it's almost
same.
Almost the same, yes. Then karma vaichitryat srishti vaichitryam.
This has come before exactly same, I remember.
Maybe you remember, but I wish you had looked at the sutras too.
Utra, there are so many sutras. I got stuck in the first chapter itself.
We are in lockdown, Utra. Maid is not there. How do you mean?
My ulterior motive was to make you revise.
I know.
We got only up to 30th verse of the first one.
All right, okay. So karma vaichitya srishti vaichitya, meaning is clear. All right. So this is occurring in 351, karma vaichitriya pradhana cheshta garbhadasavat. 351, it is also given. That covers our base. All right. Hopefully we can do some more. We are running out of time. So the next sutra is samyave shamya bhyam karyadvayam. What this means is that pradhana, it has two karyas, one in which it is samya and one in which it is vaishamya. So what has been given by the commentators is that samya avastha is there in pralay, at which time primordial matter is lying without having changed, and vaishamya avastha is the rest of the universe during srishti. So just like Anuj brought up this topic, my belief is that what is existing in pralay is not a karya, it is the karana prakriti itself. So it would not be right to call it a karya here. So what is being mentioned here is what I told you, this karana sharira, and what might be a layer of pradhana which is existing in its samya state only.
But Bhagini, I don't disagree with the argument that it is also Karya, because Karana and Karya are just our points in a time scale, right? For Pralaya, the Karana is the existence itself, the Prakriti, the current world as it exists is the Karana for Pralaya, which will become the Karya, but then it becomes a new Karana for a new Prakriti, like that it goes, no? New Srishti.
Karana, like about Karana, you are right, but when you say Karya, then it has to be a transformation of something else. So if it is not transformed for any, from anything else, which is what Moola Prakriti is about, then it is actually not right to call it a Karya. However, you can...
You are arguing that it simply goes back to its basic nature of Samya.
Yes.
And Vaishamya is what you are calling simply always as the Karya. Okay.
Yeah. Any transformation is the effect is the Karya. Okay. And when you are considering a sequence, then the Karya which is generated can itself produce something else and therefore become the Karana for the next Karya. Okay. So to that extent, the Karya Karana keeps moving up. But when you reach the end of that sequence, then you're left with only Karana. And when you on the top reach the end of the Karya, then there is no, what you mean is there is no, it does not become the Karana for another Karya. So at the two extremities, you don't have both the values available to that entity, both cause and effect. Otherwise, everything is typically a cause plus an effect.
I look at it. This is very correct. I agree with you now. I see the point. For example, they say one more thing we say is yatha yatha pindande tatha brahmande. So if you see a pendulum, yatha pindam tatha brahmandam, something like that, right?
Yatha pindi tatha brahmande.
Brahmande. So for example, if I see a simple pendulum. The pendulum goes from left to right, goes to, that is that cyclic motion, and when it comes to rest is the Samya, and again something causes the pendulum movement again, then again Vaishamya starts, and that has a limited number of cycles like that. Okay,
but however, your point also, it can be taken that when things are degrading towards Samyavastha at the time of Pralaya, when Pralaya has started happening and things are moving towards complete Pralaya. So maybe even that movement from Vaishamyavastha to Samyavastha as it is progressing slowly, that also could be considered as the Karya here. Again, this sutra is a little bit, there's a doubt here in exactly what is the meaning of this. So I have given you the two options. You can see whichever
one. I was just wondering whether he actually means Samya has two Karyas and Vaishamya has two Karyas, but I think that is totally off. Yeah.
No. Samya, Vaishamya, those are the two Karyas. Karya Dvayam.
No, because Vaishamya Bhyam Karya Dvayam is there. Not Vaishamya Yoho Karya Dvayam. Huh?
Samya, Vaishamya Bhyam. Samya, Vaishamya, that is the Itaritara Dvandva.
No, otherwise... Abhyam gives the sense of they do individually have two works like that. No, if it was just Samya Vaishamya Vaishamyau Karya Dvayam, then there would have been.
This is Tritiya Vibhakti. That in the form of Samya and Vaishamya, Samya or Vaishamya ke dwara karya do hote hain. That means that is the Sanskrit construction. Even in Hindi, it is not coming out correctly. But what it means is, in the form of Samya and Vaishamya, there are two Karyas of Prakriti.
Okay.
Then, Vimukta Bodhan Na Srishtihi. Yes, sorry.
No, I was... is there some primordial matter left that is not, you know, part of this Srishti or which has taken...
That is what Anuj asked. So that is what I had just covered in the beginning, that we have discussed that Karana Sharira, where that Karana Sharira is supposed to be made of primordial matter. So that means there is something, some primordial matter still there. And even after all of creation is over, it is possible that just like that Karan Sharira, there is this Pradhana which is lying all over the universe, again in a connected fashion, which is still there.
Yeah, even science is truthfully seeing that, because stars are formed, stars die, both are seen now.
There again, I have an issue. You cannot equate that. Even I, in my earlier days, used to think that maybe this dark matter is referring to that. But the whole thing about this primordial matter is that it is without any lakshan. You cannot it cannot be detected by anything.
No, so, through its karyatva. Through its karyatva, I am saying, not of
karya only you are determining. So you are determining only by deduction. But if you had to see any lakshan of it, any sign of it, then that sign is not available.
It is beyond us to perceive.
Yeah, there is no instrument which can detect it. There are no senses which can detect it. Nothing can detect it because it is below everything else. All right.
Agree, okay.
Okay, Vimukta Bodhana Srishtihi Pradhanasya Lokavat. So it says Vimukta Bodhat Na Srishtihi Pradhanasya Lokavat. This also had come earlier. It says that the person who has gained Viveka, who has become Vimukta, that means Jivan Mukta. So another word for Jivan Mukta only, Vimukta. So this person, because of his Viveka, Bodha here refers to Viveka. So Vimukta Bodhat Na Srishtihi Pradhanasya. Once a person has gained Vivek, once a soul has gained Vivek, that it is different from matter, then this Pradhana, it stops creation. It stops creating things for that soul. Just like in this world. In this world meaning what? Earlier it had come, Sutravat Pake. That just like Sutavat Pake. Just like the cook, he is working in the kitchen till finally he has finished cooking your dinner. After he has finished his cooking, he stops cooking. His work is done. He was there to cook dinner for you. He has been busy at it for an hour or two, and now he has finished cooking, so he is done with his job. So same thing is true for Pradhana. There was one sutra earlier also which said that the Pradhana's main role, actually let me tell you, this is the first sutra in the second chapter, which says that the whole point of Pradhana, Srishti, is actually to get the soul moksha. All this bhoga is just by the way. Okay, vimukta mokshartham swartham va pradhanasya. Pradhana is for the moksha of somebody who has gained this thing. And swartham. Swartham also means wealth. So that is for bhoga. So for moksha and bhoga, pradhana, the existence of pradhana is there. What is the implication? That pradhana, by means of pradhana only you can obtain viveka. So therefore this whole srishti is there which is trying to lead you towards mukti. Once you have got that mukti, its cooking is over. Now it doesn't have to cook anything after that. What this implies in the in practical terms is that Pradhana is cooking things up for you all through your life. That only gives you the bhogas. Okay, God has to ensure that whatever karmas you did, there the consequence is delivered to you. That delivery is by means of this srishti. So all the time the rules of karma are generating all the time. These consequences are leading to results, which is essentially srishti. So, for example, you get some very good news. So that news has been cooked up by Pradhana for you, for your happiness. Similarly, you get bad news that has been cooked up by Pradhana for you to be sad. So that is how Pradhana was cooking all this time. Now that you have determined that this karma also is actually not mine, and definitely the consequences are not mine, so then nothing comes to you. There is nothing that the Pradhana now needs to cook for you in order to give you bhoga. Okay. So that is the meaning of this sutra. All right. Any confusion? Okay. It looks like. Yes.
See, we have our own karmas to fulfill it here. Okay, so according to my karma, that prakriti, whatever the primordial matter will cook the karma for me, is it the
karma phala?
My phala, yeah, phala. So that I can exhaust my karma on that and get out of that cause and effect. No,
I would not say exhaust karma, but exhaust pap and punya.
Yeah. So. Yeah. According to that, the Pradhana will create the situation for me.
According to my karma.
Yeah, according to my karma.
Yes.
Okay. Okay, that's it.
Okay, so let us say our prayers. Or let me just recap the two sutras we have done. Samyave Shamya Phyam Karyadvayam. विमुक्त बोधान न सृष्टि ही प्रधानस्य लोकवत ओके लेट अस हियर पेयर प्लीज अनम्यूट योरसेल्फ ओम अभयम् मित्रा
अभयम् ज्ञानात् अभयम् पुरोयः अभयं नक्तम् अभयं दिवानः सर्वा आशा मम मित्रं भवतु ॐ शान्ति शान्ति शान्ति
ओके धन्यवादः पुनः मिलामः
धन्यवादः
धन्यवादः
Thank you, Utraji. Thank you.
Thank you. Dhanyavaad.
Thank you.
Bye. Thank you, buddy.
Bye.
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 Bye.